don't know how. Hey, on Periscope. Don't know how, but you did it. Hey, tap on that screen. Give me some hearts, y'all. Hey. Hey, how you doing? How you doing?
Right there with Made
Away. Amen. Amen. Hey, welcome. Welcome to the Periscope. Good afternoon. Good afternoon. Good evening. Amen. Good morning for some of y'all. Amen. Good afternoon. How you doing? How you doing? Amen. How you doing? Amen. Invite your friends. Invite your friends. Tap on that screen. Give me some hearts. Amen. Invite your friends. I've been MIA. I've been here in prayer. Amen. I've been in prayer. Shabbat. The Lord is good. Amen. Thank you for the hearts already. Amen. Today's topic, I should say, amen, is everybody has a turn. Somebody say everybody has a turn. Amen. Invite your friends if you have not. Amen. Invite your friends if you have not. We're going to be on here. I'm going to be on here not that long. Just kind of a quick scope. I'm going on my way, amen, to support a pastor here in the city. And I'm on my way to support a pastor here in the city. His name is Pastor Jeff Haygood, amen, Living Word Church, amen. He's a great man of God, and he's having his 20-year anniversary, so shout out to them, amen, and Living Word Fellowship, amen. They are doing phenomenal things out there on Fifth Avenue, amen. So if you're in Columbus and you're looking for a church and you live on Fifth Avenue, listen, support. Now listen, when I was on my way to here, on my way to support the awesome man of God, I just got done out of a meeting helping the ministry in Springfield with their event. Amen. Listen, everybody has a turn. There's going to become one day when you're going to have the moment that you've been praying for, the moment that you've been waiting for. And never think, listen, you may take 10 years, it may take 10 days, but it's called a process. Be thankful for your process that you go through. Amen. Be thankful for what you have to go through on a day-to-day basis, because it makes you stronger. It builds integrity. It builds character. It builds stamina. It builds you. Amen. With your troubles and your woes and your highs and your lows. Amen. They're building blocks. Your mistakes are your keys and pieces to your masterpiece. Amen. Amen. So thank God for the building blocks in life. Amen. Amen. My mistakes and my shortcomings made me who I am today and made me a better person. So, and understand, amen, God does not deal in condemnation. Amen. God deals, amen, in comfort. God deals, amen, in building. God deals in edifying. So listen, you know, what you went through, amen, where you may have fell short at, look at that, learn from it, wipe the dust from your feet and get back up. Amen. Too many times we beat ourselves up. Sometimes we could be our worst critic, our worst enemy, our worst adversary. Amen. Can I get an amen to that? Amen. Listen, amen, don't beat yourself up this season. Listen, you've been through too much, amen, to keep on putting yourself through too much. Amen. Sometimes just pick up your head, look to the hills, will come up your help, and your help will always come from the Lord. Amen. You know, preachers always say, I can't get no help up in here. Listen, you can get help. Amen. You can get help, and the help is the Lord. Amen. How many know God can help you out? Amen. God's seen me through some stuff that I know it was not for the Lord to be on my side. Amen. If there was not for the Lord that was on my side. So listen, God, help is on the way. Amen. So listen, you know, everyone has a turn. Somebody say, everyone, my turn is coming. Amen. Listen, your turn is coming. No, despite what, don't let the enemy talk you out of your blessing. Your turn is coming. But what do you do? What do you do in the intermediate time? What are you doing in the intermediate time until your turn comes? That's the question. That's the challenge. That's the issue that you face presently today. Amen. That's the face we're all facing presently today. Amen. Is that we must understand, my brothers, my sisters, what we do now with our time. We must spend our time wisely. We must do things, amen, with wisdom. Amen. We cannot let people rob us of our time, our energy, our money, our effort. Amen. Stop letting people rob you of people who ain't trying to go nowhere. Amen. As long as you keep giving yourself to people who ain't trying to go nowhere, you're going to find yourself not going nowhere too. Amen. What you sow is what you reap, correct? We always say that when we're angry at somebody. What you sow is what you're going to reap. Well, guess what? If I'm sowing to something that's going to be lazy and nagging, guess what? That's going to reap in my life. So you got to be careful where you sow. You sow there to go there. Amen. And so, you know, that's something my apostle, you know, Brian Keith Williams has always stated. And it's very true. Amen. Where you sow your time, your effort, your energy, your love, your mind, your mentality, yet it's where you're gonna go. Amen. That's why you gotta be careful who you connect with. Amen. Everybody has a turn. Your turn is not far off. Your turn is not a distant memory. Your turn is not a fairy tale. Listen, everyone has a turn. Amen. Your turn is coming. Amen. But what do you do, amen, in the time right now? You got to handle your business, amen. You got to handle your mentality, amen. You got to treat it like you already got it. Come on, somebody. Amen. You got to act like you already there, amen. You may not be at the job that you like. You may not be, amen, in the house that you like. But if you don't treat that thing like it already is that thing, then you won't, when your time comes, you'll fondle it. You'll drop the ball. Amen. I know many people that have great gifts and great talents and great anointings. Amen. And spend 20, 30, 30 years doing nothing. They spend 20, 30 years, amen, in the same predicament, same place, same everything. Why? Because they just let things waste away. Don't let your dreams waste away. Don't get so caught up and bound by life. You can be bound by life. Amen. Anybody can be a witness. You can be bound by your daily routine. I'm not saying, amen, to neglect your daily routine. I'm not saying not to be irresponsible, but it got to be time management where you spend at least 30 minutes focusing on your future, focusing on your vision, focusing on the things of the Lord. Amen. Life comes at you fast and life can hit you hard. Amen. But listen, that does not give us an excuse to neglect what God has told us. Amen. Many people have prophecies and many people have vision ideas and they let them die. Don't you know you can let a prophecy die? Because prophecies, all that is to give you encouragement, to give you confirmation, to give you affirmation. But what you do with the word is up to you. I can tell somebody right now on Periscope, amen, that you're going to become a multimillionaire. And that could be true. That could be the word of the Lord, right? But what do you do from the time that you receive the prophecy until the day of manifestation determines only to you? Amen. There's always an instruction that comes with prophecy. Prophecy is just not just there just to say whatever. Listen, some prophecies, amen, God has given me over the years is tell somebody, listen, let go of something. Let go of hurt. Let go of unforgiveness. Let go of pain. And people say out their mouth, yes, I'm going to let go. Yes, I'm going to let go. Tears in their eyes and all that other stuff. But yet they really don't let go. They have an emotional outburst or an emotional appeal. Amen. But they really don't let it go. It still bothers them from time to time. Amen. We got to learn how to let some stuff go. Amen. Things from our past can hold us back from our future. Amen. I'm telling you, what I know from the Lord, I'm telling you what I know from personal experience. Amen. It was one thing that I suffered in relationships in my life is because I'm always holding to the past. Can I be honest with somebody tonight? Amen. I held on to the past for so long, held on to past memories and trying to hold people up to false standards. Amen. That's something that I had to let go. I had to give to the Lord. Amen. I had to give to the Lord. Holding someone, amen, to a standard that's beneath them. Amen. A lot of times we hold standards to the future that's really from the past that's beneath our future. Amen. We thought the future was great. We thought the past was great because it was something new. But God does things greater. God takes things to a different dimension. What happens is that we just settle for the lower. And that's what the enemy wants you to do. He wants you to settle for the lower. He wants you to settle, amen, for the little $9.50 job an hour. Say, ooh, they're made $9.50. I done reached the plateau. No, you're just at the start. You're just in the preseason of life. So listen, don't be settling, amen, just for the mundane things of life. Amen. I'm a person who are always is looking for the greater. It doesn't make me a nitpicker. Doesn't make me someone's picky, but it makes me understand the power of excellence. Amen. I operate in the spirit of excellence, meaning, amen, that I know that we can always go higher. To every higher level in the spirit realm, there's always another higher level. Amen. We got to strive for higher. And that's what we should be as the body of Christ. Man, we need to strive for greater. Amen. Don't ever be satisfied for just the low things in life, but strive to be greater. Carry the spirit of excellence. Amen. That's the thing that we don't talk about in church anymore, but it's the thing that we need to preach about more. God is an excellent God. Our God moves in the spirit of excellence. Amen. Excellence does not mean perfection. Excellence means that there's a standard, and we got to uphold the standard. Listen, there's been times where I dropped the ball in my life where I did not live holy. I can't be honest with somebody. And I'm talking about from personal experience. I'm talking about there's some times where I dropped the ball because I did not carry the spirit of excellence. I dropped the ball where I did not carry the integrity like I should. I dropped the ball. Amen. Listen, we all dropped the ball. I'm just using letting you know even a man of God, anointed by God, prophet of God, amen, can drop the ball sometimes. Come on, somebody. Amen. Listen. But if you drop the ball, do not waddle in sorrow. Do not waddle in pain. Amen. Do not drown yourself in pity. Get back up, man. Get back up. You made a did something today that was not pleasing to the Lord. That's the fact of you feeling that in your heart shows that you care, so that you have the Holy Spirit. The problem is when you start doing sin and there ain't no type of conviction. And so what happens is when, because listen, it rains on the just and the unjust. So that means that, like I said at the beginning, everybody gets a turn. It rains on the just and the unjust, meaning it's, eventually it's going to rain in your life. But what have I done? What have I done to prepare myself for the rain? Amen. Have I sowed my seeds correctly? Have I sowed in good soil? And I'm not talking about this money. I'm talking about this time, energy, effort. Amen. And I'm not talking about this church. Because guess what? There's more seeds. You can sow seeds to church, right? But you can also sow seeds in your relationship, in your friendships, in your business life, in the marketplace. What seeds have I sown? Amen. So now when it rains, I want the harvest, but did I do the work? Amen. Did I do the work behind the harvest? Amen. Your seed is powerful, but when the rain comes, it makes the seed increase. Amen. So thank God for your seed. Amen. So I say, thank God for my seed. Amen. It was the seed that busted the devil's head. Your seed is powerful. Amen. I hope I'm helping somebody today. Your seed is powerful. Your seed can bust the devil's head. My God in heaven, my seed can bust the devil's head. Just imagine what it can do. Amen. To other things I'm going through. Just imagine when that seed grows. Come on, somebody. If the seed's powerful enough to give the devil a blow, let's imagine when my faith grows. Let's imagine when my praise and worship grows. My God in heaven. Amen. Thank you for the hearts. So we just want to, I just wanted to drop that in my spirit. You know, and when your turn comes, support people. Amen. Until your time comes, support. Until your time comes, love. Until your time comes, pray. And when your time do come, don't stop. Come on, somebody. Amen. Support people. That's why I like going to I don't go to a lot of people's stuff, but I go to people's stuff who I know that's living right, and I support and I sow seed. Amen. It's called sowing love. Amen. We need to show love to each other in the body of Christ. We talk about unity. The key to unity is love. Love is the glue that brings us together. Love is the glue that's going to stick us together. Amen. Listen, I'm telling you, there's been times where I dropped the ball on loving folk. Amen. There's been times where I dropped the ball on loving folk. Amen. There's been times where I got caught up in my own self. Amen. I'm just being honest. And I'm not saying that I'm a prideful person. I'm not. But I'm just saying sometimes it's easy. You can get caught up, amen, in your own thing. And guess what? Shunning people out that really care about you. Amen. Shunning people out that really have your back. Because you've been in a place where you've been alone for so long that you don't even know how to receive help. You don't know how to receive. You don't even know how to receive, amen, even true love anymore. Amen. And sometimes we think love ain't real because we haven't seen it in so long. Can I be honest today? Amen. On a Thursday, on a beautiful Thursday, warm, beautiful Thursday. Amen. But some people right now watching, amen, you've been struggling with this, accepting just the simple things of life, accepting help from somebody, thinking that somebody always got an interior motive. And listen, it's okay to have guards. Amen. It's okay. Don't go into anything foolishness. Don't think I'm telling you this to be foolish and just open yourself up to anything and everything. No. Use wisdom. But also don't think wisdom is going to tell you keep yourself closed up. Amen. It's not. Sometimes you're going to need to open up. There's some things you can't handle. You're going to need somebody to magnify the Lord with you. The Bible says, oh, magnify the Lord with me. Meaning, listen, I'm going to need sometimes some help. Then somebody going to touch and agree with me. There's going to be some times where I'm going to be weak in my flesh. Amen. It's okay to need help. Amen. It's okay, amen, to have somebody touch and agree with you. Listen, it's just not okay to have everybody around you. Come on, somebody. It's just not okay to give everybody your business. Come on. But use wisdom on who you confide in. Amen. Make sure that they are a brother. Make sure they are a sister. Because a brother knows how to be a keeper. Come on, somebody. Amen. And I think, and that's what God is calling the church, amen, then we can love again. Listen, and when I mean the church, I'm talking about more than just, you know, your membership, but I'm talking about just the body of Christ. Amen. We should be able to love, support, and grow as one. Amen. I'm not, one thing about me and one thing I've always been about, and I give God the glory, but I've always been about supporting the kingdom. You know what I'm saying? I've always been about pushing people in their ministry and knowing what people's gifts are and utilizing them to their strengths of their gifts. Amen. And that's really true ministry. That's true love. Amen. We got to get to that place where we're raising up leaders and not raising up spectators, raising up people, amen, that want the presence of God. I was on Facebook this morning. I was so disturbed in my spirit, real disturbed. I'm seeing a lot of people preaching, and listen, I find it to be wonderful to see people step out on their gifts. Don't think I'm that type of person. I believe in apostolic doctrine. Apostolic doctrine talks about raising up gifts, raising up sons and daughters, raising up leaders. I believe in that, but we got to raise them up correctly. Amen. I remember a time where people got set down in ministry. Amen. It wasn't there to hold your destiny back, but it was there for you to learn, for you wouldn't hurt yourself. Amen. We need to get back to some of those things and those ways. Amen. Where people got to, and listen, young ministers, you got to be humble enough to receive rebuke every now and then. I've never seen so many young ministers so touchy feely. My God, if someone tells you, you sit down, you made a mistake, and then you just think they holding you back from your destiny, now you want to leave. Amen. My name on Facebook is Jay Jordan, JayJordan. You gotta be humble. Listen, when I started ministry, true story, when I started ministry, this is gonna help somebody who's in ministry. Told my pastor, I said, Pastor, I'm called to preach. And he said, you sure? I said, you know what? I'm not sure myself, but God, I'm sure in what God says. Is that what I told him? I wasn't sure. Because I was shy, I was quiet. Amen. I'm actually very shy by nature. And the Lord was just calling me. And I quit a job that I was making almost $5,000 a week. That's a lot of money. Amen. I quit it by faith. I went down from making $5,000 to making about maybe $600 a week. You know, that's a dramatic drop. And I did it by faith. Listen, it was not easy. Don't think I did it and everything was peaches and cream. No, it was hard. It was hard, but guess what? God provided every step of the way. I didn't lose not one thing. Amen. It taught me, amen, faith. It taught me true faith. That's why I can just stand on faith, on crazy faith now, because that was just a stepping stone to great faith. It was hard. And so when I told my pastor that, I wasn't sure what the process was going to be. I didn't know I had to take school. I didn't know none of that. He put me on the sound booth. My pastor put me on the sound booth, y'all. I was on the sound booth. I did sound for 3 years almost. I think 2 or 3 years. Jay Jordan, JayJordan. I did sound. And it was almost like when the karate kid, when Mr. Miyagi was telling him to wash his car, he said, man, well, you got me washing your car. That ain't teaching me karate, but really he was learning the technique. Amen. And what happens is that sometimes, amen, God will put you in a system. You say, God, this don't make no sense. You called me to the nations, but you got me in a call center talking to the nations. Come on, somebody. God, you called me the minister of the people, but you got me out here unemployed. I got to go and talk to people, and I'm supposed to be called to own a business. I'm unemployed, but I got to have interviews and meetings and HR and really developing skills, amen, so when you get your business, you know how to hire somebody. Come on, somebody. Sometimes we think what is terrible is really a learning curve. I mean, we're learning something. Amen. God is learning. God, the reason why you're in your predicament, because you're learning the skills that you're going to need for where you're going to go. My God in heaven, I just felt that. Amen. Sometimes we don't even understand that the process that we in ain't really that bad. The process we in is building us up. Amen. How many people know that you're in a process to build you up, not to destroy you? But the more you complain in your process, the less you can obtain. The day when you get the complaining and the worrying out of your system, come on, somebody, you will get into the place where you obtain perfect peace. You'll get into the place, amen, you attain perfect joy. You'll get into a place, amen, where you obtain, amen, peace that will pass all understanding. You'll get into the place, amen, where you say, thank God be the glory. Come on. God be the glory anyhow. I don't know about anybody else, but God be the glory anyhow. And so learning that, I learned humility when I was in the sound booth. I learned the do's and the don'ts. I learned how to flow in the spirit correctly. I learned so many different things. Amen. And here's the thing about it. I just didn't start out the gate preaching. Amen. That's for somebody right there. I didn't come out the gate preaching. Amen. I came out the gate learning. I came out the gate being humble. I came out the gate learning how to be steadfast. I came out the gate, amen, holding my peace. I came out the gate, amen, understanding, amen, that there's a process that we got to go through. And understanding, amen, the do's and the don'ts in ministry. And understanding what it means to be humble. Amen. And that's why I'm so humble in ministry. And that's why I can preach the gospel now and just give all glory to God. Amen. Because I understand humility. I understand, listen, the gospel's bigger than me. Amen. The gospel is bigger than me because I spent time learning that. I spent time being humble. I spent time being humble before the Lord and letting God, listen, letting God do a work in me. amen, at a young age. Amen. It was never a question if I could preach or anything like that. It was never a question if I could prophesy accurately. Amen. It was a question of, can you be humble? Amen. And I think a lot of young ministers need to learn that humility factor. Amen. Listen, I'm talking about as a young man. Amen. Humility in the process will give you longevity. Amen. Somebody write that down. Humility grants longevity. Amen. If you can be humble, then you can stay in your place of promise. Amen. Humility grants longevity. Amen. So you got to be humble. Amen. You got to be humble. I cannot stress that enough. I've seen many, many, many great, great preachers. Amen. They lose their minds. Amen. Trying to be big mega time this and big mega time that. And really, amen, just be humble before the Lord. Amen. I would rather be a humble servant of God. Amen. Than this some type of bit name, get my name everywhere. No, just be humble, man. Just be a humble, long servant of God. Amen. And God will see you through. God has seen me through some stuff. Hallelujah. I don't know about anybody else, but God's seen me through some stuff. Amen. But it's because of my humility. It's because of my patience. Because of me understanding that, listen, amen, it's bigger than me. Amen. I'm here at this wonderful church. This is my dude church. Amen. First time being here. And I didn't know his parking lot was this crazy. I've been driving out his parking lot for like 3 minutes. Listen, I love my dude, Pastor Jeff Haygood. He's here in the city of Columbus. I'm surprised at him. He doesn't know I'm coming. I wasn't planning on coming, but the Holy Spirit kind of told me to do it. So thank God for me being humble to the Holy Spirit. But the Holy Spirit told me to come out here, support him. And we met 4 or 5 months ago. We've been following each other on Facebook for a long time. And we just met 4 or 5 months ago. And I thank God for him and his longevity, his servitude. Amen. And he invited me a couple months ago to come and support. And I said I would. And so I'm here tonight supporting him. 20 years in ministry is phenomenal. He's a lovely wife, lovely family. Amen. He's a true general here in the city. Amen. And, you know, my thing is I believe in supporting. That's why that stirred all this stuff up. Amen. Support each other. Listen. Amen. I believe in that strongly because, amen, you want somebody to support you one day. As my grandfather would say. Amen. You want somebody to support you one day. So, you know, hold steadfast to the things, to the things of the Lord, and be faithful. Amen. Be supportive and be loving. I think of this man of God highly. Amen. He's a great man of God of integrity. He's a great church here in Columbus. Amen. And I believe, amen, in supporting the body of Christ. Amen. The world supports each other. We need to support each other too. Amen. And that's the truth. Amen. For those who know anything, the world will support each other. Amen. I don't know. Y'all pray for me. Y'all pray for me. These parking spots are not designed for Mercury Grand Marquis. I got a Mercury. You know, Mercury got big ends. Amen. Y'all pray for my baby. Amen. Listen, I'm here. Amen. We are here at the church. I love each and every one of y'all. I will be on here for the night scope. Amen. I will be on here for the night scope. I'll be on here probably about 9:30-ish, 10. I'm not staying for the full service, but I'll probably be on about 9:30, 10. But it's a beautiful area, this Fifth Avenue. Great, great, great place for outreach ministry. So, love y'all. Keep me in prayer. And we got a lot of business. We got great, great opportunities coming up this weekend. So keep us in prayer. I've been praying to the Lord. Amen. I've been in a major prayer the last couple weeks. Amen. So keep us in prayer about that. That God is going to open up some doors. Amen. I'll be scoping tonight. I love y'all for the love of Christ. Peace. I'll try to scope from the service. See what's going on.